The old Noxubee County Jail once held inmates, but soon it will have a new use.
For a little over 2 years, supervisors have been discussing ideas for the vacant building. Now, one of those ideas will become a reality. Our Jory Talley joins us in the studio with more. Jory.
That's right. Within the last week, the board approved the old jail to serve as a holding facility for the coroner, but only part of the building will be used as a morgue.
R.L. Calhoun served as Noxubee County's coroner for 18 years. Now, for the first time in his career, his office will have a morgue. This means he'll no longer have to rely on local funeral homes to hold bodies until they can be sent to the state medical examiner's office for autopsies. And he can preserve the chain of evidence.
Now I have time to store my bodies, have time to do my investigation thoroughly. Me and law enforcement as well, we can work together like we've been doing, but now we can do it at our own pace. We don't have to be inside a funeral home and jeopardizing the case and have certain people coming in and out seeing the bodies, without our consent.
Macon Police Chief Divine Beck agrees.
We can also use our timely matter. We don't have to be in a hurry on our investigation, a stabbing death or a shooting death. We can just take our time, look over the body, investigate it, and go from there.
Calhoun says he is grateful for the cooperation with the funeral homes, but he believes having his own place will cut down on confusion for the families of the deceased.
Then I had to explain to families, the body's only here for holding, not you don't have to stay. But as some other families feel, they don't want to do it that way. They really have it the way that the board and I have come up with now. And I think the citizens of this county is excited about it.
The coroner says he really started pushing for the idea after six Gulf Coast funeral homes felt discriminated against by the Harrison County coroner for not using them enough to store bodies.
As we learned lately, lawsuits are being filed against coroners for using funeral homes.
Supervisors say the coroner will be able to hold two bodies at a time in the facility. They believe costs to do that will be less than $1,000 a year.
We just got to buy air conditioning and pay for the electricity in one room, and that's all we planned on doing.
Because we don't want to do anything that will cause the taxpayers any more increase in taxes. I've never been in favor of raising taxes because we pay too much taxes already.
Warner says renovation costs have not been set at this time. He says he plans on everything being done by this fall.